This video is prepared by Avya Classes. Please subscribe the channel, raise your doubt and watch the video for sure success in JEE, AIIMS and NEET. Now we consider the case of different masses, in fact very different masses. One body is very heavy and other one is very light object. So if massive projectile collides with a light target, that is here M1 is much greater than M2. So if I draw this figure, then this is M1, this is M2, and M1 is much greater than M2. So it's moving with a velocity U1, it's moving with a velocity U2. So what you will do in this case, you will consider the M2 approximately equal to 0 in comparison to M1. So this is the case of body after collision, this is the case of body. So after collision, this body is moving with a velocity v1 and this body is moving with a velocity v2. So at the first instance, it seems very clear to you that if a heavy object collides with a light object, then there is minimal impact in the heavy object. So because of that, the heavy object continue to be moving with the same velocity. So we may say that v1 must be equal to u1, or it's approximately equal to u1. And from the formula we will get the very same thing, that is, if the massive projectile collides with a light target, then v1 is equal to, given by this formula, and v2 given by this formula. So we just put m2 approximately equal to 0. So m2, if I put the m2 approximately equal to 0 at its very small comparison to m1, then if I put the value here, then v1 is equal to m1 by m1 into u1 plus 0. So v1 comes equal to u1, and it is as per our intuition also. And v2 is equal to minus m1 divided by m1 into u2 plus twice m1 by m1 into u1. So from there we get it's equal to 2 u1 minus u2. So the velocity of the second body becomes equal to twice u1 minus u2. So the velocity of this body, M2 body, will be equal to 2 times the velocity of u1 minus the velocity with which it was moving earlier. So if the second body was in rest earlier, then after collision it will get a velocity twice equal to the initial velocity of a massive projectile. So all those things are shown in this figure also, that when the collision of a truck with a cyclist, here the mass of truck will large in comparison to mass of cyclist, and in this case we may see that the velocity of truck remains unchanged while the velocity of cyclist become equal to twice u1 minus u2. So if you calculate the value of 2 u1 minus u2 as per this figure, we get equal to 2 into 120 minus 60, and it's equal to 240. Oh, it's equal to 10. So 240 minus 10, that is equal to 230. So if you see that in this figure, the velocity of cyclist after collision becomes equal to 230 km per hour from 10 km per hour. Now we see the sub case when U2 is equal to 0. So when U2 is equal to 0, then we get V1 is equal to U1 and V2 is equal to twice U1. So it is written here. So clearly the impact in case of second body being rest will be more, because when the second body or the lighter object is moving with a velocity u2, then the velocity after collision will be equal to v2 is equal to twice u1 minus u2. Whereas if it is in a rest, then the velocity after collision is equal to twice u1. So clearly in this case, the velocity in the case when the body, when the target is in the rest, then the velocity after collision will be more than the velocity when the target is moving. Now we will see the case of collision between a light projectile and a heavy target. So if we consider this figure, that when the projectile will be light, so if it is m1, this is m2, where m1 is very less than m2. This is moving with velocity u1, this is moving with velocity v2, and after collision they will have velocity v1 and v2 respectively. So this is equal to v1 and this is equal to v2. So clearly that when m1 is very less in comparison to m2, then we can treat m1 approximately equal to 0. So if I substitute m1 is equal to 0 in the formula of v1 and v2, then we get that v1 is equal to, first we put m1 is equal to 0, so it's equal to minus m2 divided by m2 u1 plus twice m2 divided by m2 u2. So from there we get it's equal to twice u2 minus u1. So v1 is equal to twice u2 minus u1, while v2 is equal to u. And if I calculate the value of v2, then v2 is equal to m2 divided by m2 u2 plus 0. So v2 is equal to m2, v2 is equal to u2, and clearly it is as per our intuition also, that if a light projectile hits a heavy target, then the velocity of heavy target remains unaffected. So the v2 must be equal to u2 and v1 is equal to twice v1 is equal to twice u2 minus u1. So in perfectly elastic head-on collision, so this is shown in this figure. We have already learned that in case of perfectly elastic head-on collision, when two bodies are moving with velocity u1 and u2, and before collision and after collision they will start moving with a velocity v1 and v2, then we can apply the law of conservation of energy, law of conservation of kinetic energy, and as the coefficient of restitution will be equal to 1. So first, when we apply the law of conservation of momentum, we get the formula m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. And when we apply the law of conservation of kinetic energy, then it is equal to half m1 u1 square plus half m2 u2 square is equal to half m1 v1 square plus half m2 v2 square. Similarly, as the coefficient of restitution is equal to 1, so relative velocity of approach is equal to relative velocity of separation. So u1 minus u2 is equal to v2 minus v1. So based on these three, we get the formula of velocity of mass m1 and m2 after collision. And it is equal to velocity of mass m1 after collision is equal to v1, and it is given by m1 minus m2 divided by m1 plus m2 into u1 plus twice m2 u2 divided by m1 plus m2. And similarly, v2 is equal to m2 minus m1 divided by m1 plus m2 into u2 plus twice m1 u1 divided by m1 plus m2. So in order to remember this formula, you just remember that if it is a v1, then here it should be u1 and it starts with with m1, and in the second term it must be m2. So similarly in case of v2, it starts with the u2, and in the numerator of first term it's m2 minus m1, while in the numerator of second term it must be m1. So in this way we can recall this formula. Now we have also learned the special cases of head on elastic collision, and first is the if a projectile and target of the same mass, that is m1 is equal to m2. So when m1 is equal to m2, we have learned that v1 is equal to u2 and v2 is equal to u1, that is if the two bodies of same mass are moving with a velocity equal to u1 and u2. So if these two bodies are A and B, then after collision their velocity gets interchanged. So its velocity is equal to u2 and its velocity is equal to u1. So we have learned this concept, and for equal masses under head-on collision their velocity gets interchanged. So if a body is moving while the target is in rest, suppose it is in the rest and this body is moving with the velocity u, then after collision this body A become rest and this body B will start moving with the velocity equal to u. Now we have learned the case of when the massive projectile collides with a light target. So when massive projectile collides with a light target, then there will not be change in the velocity of massive projectile, and in this case the v1 is equal to u1. So there is no any change in the velocity of massive projectile, while the velocity of light target after collision becomes v2 is equal to twice u1 minus u2. So we have also learned that in the sub case, that is when u2 is equal to 0, that is target is at rest, then v1 is equal to u1 and v2 is equal to 2u1. In third case, when a light projectile collides with a heavy target, that is m1 is very less than m2, that is suppose this is our light projectile m1 and this is a very heavy target m2, and when it's collide with, this is moving with velocity u1 and this heavy target moves with the velocity u2, and after collision clearly there will not be any change of velocity of mass m2, so v2 is equal to u2 and this v1 is equal to twice u2 minus u1. So based on the value of v1, if it comes with a positive sign, then this light projectile will continue to move in the initial direction, and if it comes with a negative sign, then clearly the light projectile moves in opposite direction. So it's written here that v1 is equal to twice u2 minus u1 and v2 is equal to 0, and in the sub case u2 is equal to 0, when this mass m2 is in rest, then v1 is equal to minus u1 and v2 is equal to 0. So the ball rebounds with the same speed in opposite direction when it collides with a stationary and very massive ball.